Okay, so in our previous lecture, we were learning fundamental principles of generating voltmeter, field millet, etc. Now it is continued further. So let us recapitulate before going further, just for continuity. So this was the generating voltmeter, or field mill or rotary voltmeter. So you have seen how the current is captured at the electrode A, and then if E is uniform, the rectified average current is proportional to the field. So this concept is used for measurement of atmospheric fields of small magnitudes. Wilson was the person to use this. Now voltage measurement concept was also introduced. This is by I of t is equal to dt of C into V. It was shown proportional to voltage V if it is DC voltage, right? Somebody's mic is echoing. Please switch off the mic. Okay. Now, different kinds of generating voltmeters use this basic equation, basic principle. Only their designs will differ in constructional means for providing CT and interpretation of current I. Almost all the generating voltmeters work on this basic principle. That's what we have seen. So variable area A of T or variable capacitance C of T. So it is not difficult to manipulate the waveforms of A of T and C of T. So until now we have seen only triangular wave, right? Triangular wave. But it can be sinusoidal also. The capacitance variation or area variation, you have seen such kind of waveform. So, but it can be sinusoidal also, but most often the sinusoidal will have some certain DC component, not exactly, actual sinusoidal. Actual sinusoidal means sinusoidal plus some DC component will be there most often, that either C of T or A of T if you plot. So it is possible, of course, to make it, sawtooth like, and then even vary the shape of the exposing electrodes. By varying that, we can change the or modify the waveform a little bit. So already we have studied for triangular waves. Now please try for sinusoidal waveforms as an exercise. So if CT is like this, then how it can be done? And so the hint here is assume C is equal to C naught plus some Cm cos omega t or sin omega t. So it will be like this. Right? But remember, when you differentiate this, what will happen? The C naught is a constant, right? So it is as good as differentiating Cm cos omega t. Okay, so this will be in DC case. V into again DC by DT you will be using here. So with that you will get V Cm omega sine omega t, right? So again it is proportional to V, and it can, you can get RMS value and then you know, even rectified average value. So both moving iron and moving coil instruments can be used to get these values, and you can correlate the current, average current or RMS current to voltage, and it is proportional to V. So this is the concept. So same, just do some calculations, you will get it. Next, can we measure for AC? Yesterday also we have discussed. See, simplest way is to keep C as constant, not varying with time. If you keep C as constant, I equals to C dV by dt, right? So if you use V, if you take V as Vm sin omega t or cos omega t, right, this is in the AC case, you will get for half wave rectification, I am giving the final values here, C Vm omega by pi. And for full wave rectification, it will be simply 2 times 2C Vm omega by pi. And for RMS values, C Vm omega by root 2. Please solve it and then verify. Simple, this in this case it is very simple. It is I is equal to C dV by dt only. And from that, half wave you take, find out average over entire period, and full wave you take, rectification means the negative half cycle also you have to consider as positive only, and then average it out. It will be simply 2 times this value. And after that, RMS you find it out. RMS you know of sinusoidal wave, you can directly use 1 by root 2. So this is how you can measure AC voltages. If C is kept constant, in this case C is kept constant, right? But C can also be changing. What if C is changing? No, the charge Q is equal to V of T into C of T or CV, right? Q of T, let us say. Now current I equals to dq by dt. If both of them are changing, both V and C are changing, you have to write d by dt of V of T into C of T, right? Like this. Now if both of them are changing, and if capacitance is changing, you know, with a triangular waveform like this. If capacitance is a triangular waveform like this. So if this is Cm, what was the equation for C, C of T? Someone tell me the equation. This C of T for, you know, until T by 2. T by 2. Until T by 2, what was the equation? Yesterday we have written.
The 2 Cm by M by T into T.
2 Cm
by capital T into T.
Capital T into
small t.
This was the equation for C of T. And V of T. V of T, if it is the AC case, see, it is Vm sin omega t, let me write. You can write cos omega t also. There may be phase difference also. Right? So V of T is called Vm sin omega t. Now, how the waveform will look like? C into V, the product C into V. Okay, let me write that equation again. I of t equals to d by dt of c of t v of t. Now if c of t is a triangular wave like this and V of t, see here there is a difference. What is this time period t, t by 2, t, etc.? What are these?
The time the movable electron moves and comes back.
The time the
movable electron completes one whole cycle is t, sir.
So it is related to the mechanical system which is moving, right? It is movable electrodes frequency. 1 by t corresponds to, 1 by capital T corresponds to movable electrodes frequency, whether it is rotating or simply moving. So it is its frequency. Now voltage V of t is electrical quantity, right? So yes, the Vm sin omega t, here this omega is different. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is electrical frequency. So it can be smaller than this or it can be higher than this, right? If it is smaller than this means the number of cycles of electrical quantity, electrical voltage is less than the number of cycles of, you know, this mechanical electrode, then can we measure such a quantity? Simple logical. In other words, if frequency of voltage is less than the frequency of triangular wave,
no sir, it will pass.
We cannot measure because see the triangular wave cannot even see one complete cycle of AC voltage in that case, right? How can you get average and then can measure? So it is not possible. So always the frequency of sinusoidal signal or voltage signal should be more than this one, more than this capacitor. Change a variable capacitor. So in that case, so you can assume the minimum is the frequency of both of them is equal. So the second case is 2 times that one. So like this, you can assume the frequencies and then for different frequencies, this is the voltage signal, right? Now multiplication of these two, how it will look like? Multiplication of these two, how it will look like? Let me draw here itself on this. If you multiply a triangular wave with a sinusoidal wave, how you will get, assuming that, you know, for the time being, assume that everything, see, everything we are getting output. Because if you rectify, the negative portion will not come. But now, assume the complete waveform, let us draw, how it will be. Okay, you know, zero into something is zero, right? Whenever sinusoidal signal becomes zero, then obviously zero into whatever triangular signal you are multiplying, whatever value of the triangular signal be, it will be zero only. So all the zeros of sinusoidal voltage will correspond to zeros only. So these are all 0 points, right? Sorry, this is peak. Okay, now what will happen to the peaks of sinusoidal voltage? So these are all zeros now. These points are zeros. Okay, what will happen to the peak value when it multiplied with the triangular voltage? Ignore Vm. Sin omega t maximum value how much? 1, right? Someone should say yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, the peak value when you multiply with the triangular signal, then simply it is the value, it will be the value of triangular signal only. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And if it is Vm sin omega t, so it will be simply the value magnitude Vm multiplied by the triangular. So it is proportional only. So it looks like the all the peaks will be under the envelope of a triangular wave. But this will happen in the negative side also. So the waveform will look like I'm unable to draw here. Yeah, it is coming. Now again, this like this. Again in the triangular envelope. I'm drawing roughly, but this is how it will look like. This is the waveform, product CT into VT. Right? Mathematically, if you do d by dt of C of t is 2 cm, 2 cm, what was it?
2 cm by t into t.
Into t. Into Vm sin omega t. Into Vm sin omega t. All the constant terms you take it out. 2 cm Vm by t d by dt of t sin omega t. This is simply multiplication factor. It is a curve t sine omega t. So if you differentiate these, you will get two terms. Once you have to hold t and then differentiate sine omega t, So it will become omega t cos omega t plus sin omega t into t sin omega t. So this term multiplied by 2cm vm by t is what you will get for I actually. So we have seen how simply the capacitance was changing. So within the envelope of triangular wave. So it is called modulated signal actually, modulation. So it can be demodulated electronically and then the voltage can be measured. It's not difficult, but how to do with, you know, the problem with electronic systems in high voltage, you know, right? We traditionally and even now, we prefer to measure the voltages using, you know, mechanical systems because they are very less affected by the influence of high voltages. Otherwise, electronic equipment may suddenly fail. So you do not know what happens. Even inside, even some devices start malfunctioning and you may get erratic results also. So it is not so reliable to use such a systems. Of course, for routine measurements we may use, but for standard measurements, mechanical systems will work better for high voltage at least. So how to get you know, voltage from such a signal, we will see when actual mechanical system is studied. One of the example is studied. So at that time we will discuss again. So here I have given the example of CFT as a triangular wave, CFT as a triangular wave, and then VFT triangular wave with G offset, right? Like this. And VFT sinusoidal. But it is possible that CFT can also be sinusoidal. So in that case, it becomes a little bit, you know, simple because product of two sines. So you can convert that into sine plus sine or cos plus cos kind of thing. And if the frequencies are matching, one of the terms will you know, become zero. So frequencies and phase is matching. So otherwise also it will have certain offset that will go in the in differentiation. So that we will see later. So for the time being, I will close here with AC case. AC case, we will deal with this in more detail when we deal with the rotating voltmeter. So now, I think you are able to see this. Now this is just a little modification of the previous generating voltmeter. Here, instead of moving electrode, vibrating electrode is used. So you see there is no moving electrode here, but the A, the central electrode, which itself will be moving. Moving means will be vibrating. So with that vibration, what will happen? Suppose if this is moving up means towards HV electrode, or in other words, the gap between HV electrode and the central electrode A is reducing. In that case, what will happen? Someone.
Field distribution changes.
Field distribution changes. In what way?
Like which side moves up will have.
Most.
Like the intensity of the field changes which side goes up, sir, and the other will experience less field compared to the other field which is on top.
Yeah, field distribution, field intensity increases, right?
Yes, sir.
Because field lines become more stronger. Or yes, if sir. Two electrodes are...
Capacitance will change, sir.
Yeah, that is another way of looking at it. Capacitance will change. Capacitance will decrease or increase?
Sir, capacitance will decrease, sir.
Capacitance will decrease. Why?
The charges, Q is equal to CV, sir. Charges will decrease, sir.
Charges will decrease.
Capacitance will increase, sir, because D is
distance, if the distance is decreased, capacitance will increase.
Yes, sir.
So, charges will decrease or increase now?
Increase, sir.
Increase,
sir. Q is equal to CV. So, charges will increase. So, charges will increase and the charge density, whatever is, you know, given here, this will also
increase.
So if this central electrode is vibrating up and down, just I will show you the, you know, animation here, like this. So this is, observe this, this is charge density. Charge density also changes simultaneously. Okay, now how this will work? If charge density is changing like this, then mathematically how to proceed? How CFT will be changing? See here,
you know,
in terms of triangularly increase and decrease.
Triangularly, which one?
So capacitance.
What is the formula for capacitance? Suppose you assume plane parallel geometry. Capacitance is epsilon into A by D, right?
Yes, sir.
Here, A is constant.
Yes, sir.
Epsilon is constant again. D will only be changing. So capacitance is inversely proportional to D.
Yes, sir.
But does this mean that it is not triangularly changing?
Hyperbolic, sir.
It is simple. So let this be mean position of the electrode where it is D. Switch off your mic, then you are not speaking. Noise coming, switch off your mics when you are not speaking. So this is D, where the central electrode A is located, and this is HV electrode. And from this mean position, the electrode is vibrating between these two positions, let us assume, like this, up and down. And again up and down, like this. So this is the mean position, and over and above the mean position, it is moving up and down, right? Now, in this case, I can write D as, you know, D dash or new value of D as D plus small x, right? So C of T x of t rather. So C of t is epsilon a by d plus x of t. Right? Now if x of t is less than d, x is normally less than d, very small quantity. So the vibrations are very small magnitude. In that case, how can this be approximated?
Epsilon a by d. Epsilon a by d.
No, in that case you will not get anything. You are saying it is constant.
CT would be constant. CT would be constant.
CT will be constant. No. It will be changing, right? You have to consider at least first order changes. Okay. You cannot completely say that, okay. If you consider in a large scale, okay, differences in C are very small. That I also agree. But those small changes only you have to capture and then estimate the voltage, right? So if you will, say C of t will be constant, then nothing can be done.
So we will take d common and take the denominator term in numerator, and one plus x by d, that will be going to the numerator and it will become 1 minus x by d.
Yeah. So now this is epsilon a by d into 1 plus x by d. So this goes to numerator. Right? Everyone understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if you differentiate this dc by dt, what you will get? Minus of epsilon a by d square dx by dt, right?
Yes, sir.
Now you can get some idea on what it is. DC by DT will change. DC by DT. We are concerned with the DC by DT only, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, let X. X is what? What is X here?
The vibration distance for a move.
And what direction, what reference direction I have taken as positive for X?
Upwards, sir.
I have taken as positive. If upwards I have taken as positive, should I write d plus x or d minus x in the denominator in the beginning?
D minus x.
I should have written, right?
Yes, I have written d plus x.
It's downwards, sir.
Downwards. Have taken as positive. You can take the different opposite direction also. In that case, you will not get this minus sign.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So X in general will be moving, you know, up and down, right? So you may assume either linear movement or sinusoidal movement. Everything is possible because it is simple linear movement like this. Why I have put negative here? Will it go to negative?
It's a decrement of a capacitance, sir.
No, no, this is X of T I am writing. Not capacitance.
Sir, it will go upward. If you take a decrement, and then it will go upward. This opposite sense.
Okay, so upward and downward, both the directions it will go. Now, am I correct in writing this waveform or not? X of T.
Yes, sir.
Can it take negative values or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, it can take.
Yes, sir. If you take a reference, then it go below to reference and come to the reference and go above the reference. That's why it come negative, sir.
Exactly. Because my reference is the mean position of D. So that is why I can write like this. But it doesn't matter to us because ultimately we have to differentiate X, right? So if you differentiate X, what are you writing about? What you will get in the differentiation? You will get the slopes only, right?
Yes.
So yes, dx by dt into this quantity epsilon a by d square multiplication. So now there is a negative sign here for my reference. If you take a different reference, means, you know, if you take a upward direction as positive, then you will not get this minus. But I got minus because I have taken downward direction as the reference direction. So therefore, my slope will always become ulta. Minus of dx by dt will be minus of whatever I get the slope for x of t. So dc by dt I'm writing. This is dc by dt. DC by DT waveform will be again pulsating like this. This is a positive slope will become negative, negative slope will become positive. So this is DC by DT. Now the current I equals to, if you apply DC voltage, V into DC by DT, V DC by DT. So this will be also pulsating in this case, provided the magnitude of X, maximum amplitude of X is less than D. This condition you have to remember, less than D. Okay, so this is also similar to the previous case. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Because waveform for a triangular wave, you are getting exactly pulsating wave only. Only that the triangular wave in this case taking negative values, but that doesn't matter for us because we are concerned with the slopes only. So with this also we are getting exactly similar waveforms for DC by DT, and therefore similar average values, RMS values, and then even with a half wave rectification, full wave rectification are possible. So exactly similar equipment can be used, just as we have studied earlier. So same as that equipment can be used, like diode or moving iron or moving coil, and then readings can be obtained, voltage can be measured, even electric field can be measured. So the next concept, if I start, it will take roughly around 1 hour or at least 40-45 minutes it will take. So I will break here and we will meet tomorrow again and complete that. Okay, do you have any questions? No questions?
Sir, as previously Harshit asked, that range is same as 10 micron PSM.
Ah, yes. Current, right?
Yes, sir. Change of current.
Current will be in that order only. See, current, your current when you are asking, this is general, general range I am telling you.
Okay.
But it also depends on the voltage. If you are, if you do not apply any voltage, you will not get any current. And sensitivity, unless you apply some minimum voltage, you may not get the, you may not get any current values. So it all depends on the exact voltage what you are using, and what, how the, how it is constructed, etc. But you can assume the capacitance, because it is in air, is in the order of picofarads, right?
Okay. Yes, sir.
If it is in the picofarads, and with that dimensions and all, general approximate values of current you can mathematically derive also.
Yes.
Okay, but in general it will be in the range of, in the order of micro amperes for normal voltages that are measured in the high voltage labs.
Sir, out of the both voltmeters studied, which one is preferred?
Which one is
preferred for measurements?
So actually these are, this is basic principle only I have given you, but among these, which one is better, you have to think logically. If you think, is it better to move a measuring electrode?
It is better to move a measuring electrode instead of moving electrode.
Better to move measuring electrode.
Moving electrode, sir. Moving. Previous type.
So it is better not to disturb the measuring electrode. Okay. If it has to mechanically vibrate, na, so then it will have a lot of consequences. Mechanical wear and tear will be there, and then you may have to calibrate frequently, and it may give wrong readings also, errors also. So better not to move the measuring electrode. So only if you have separate movable electrode, and separate movable electrode covers the, you know, electrode, and you, if you get the current, that will be better. So among these two, the first one is preferable.
Sir, one question strike in my mind that, sir, a previous one, that moving electrode moves, then there will be an inductive effect also, just like similar in commutation effect of a DC motor or DC generator. There is an inductive effect comes when a commutator moves around.
No, no, there is a difference here. What are the, you see, inductance becomes important only if the currents are significant.
Okay, okay, sir. No, sir, okay.
Okay, inductance means what? Inductance will induce magnetic field only when current flows through it, right?
Yes, sir.
But if the current itself is in microamperes,
yes,
okay,
sir.
It is not the case of a motor.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
That is why the difference between high voltage and then high voltage engineering and then dielectric engineering and others, you know, power electronics, etc., or, you know, even motors, generators. This is the fundamental difference. The currents in case are very less. So inductive effects we normally neglect, and capacitive effects we will consider. Of course, you know, small you know, measuring equipment is there now, where the inductive inductance of the lead itself will matter, you know, that is different story. But normally inductances are not considered, but capacitances are given due weightage. Any other question?
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Sir, in this vibrating electrode type, we did this calculation for the DC, right?
We did calculation for DC, yes.
Because the voltage was constant. So how will the calculation will proceed for the AC?
Exactly same, right?
But we also discussed that we have to from modulated signal, we have to demodulate and then measure the voltage. So
yeah,
that
exactly
is the problem.
Exactly same. I mean, for the previous case, since the waveforms are same, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Exactly same as previous case, what is discussed today. Okay.
Okay.
So there also this modulation will happen. So you have to demodulate electronically. Otherwise, okay. Also there is an option that I will discuss in the next class. It will be lengthy. In the next class, how we will without demodulating electronically, how we will be able to measure using again moving coil instrument, say for example. So okay. It is possible, but for certain frequencies it is possible. That we will discuss tomorrow.
Okay sir, thank you sir.
Yeah, any other questions others have to ask? Vinay.
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
Okay, then we will meet tomorrow again.